This video is to show you ActivInspire's ExpressPoll feature. In order to use the ExpressPoll, you must have an active hub connected to the Promethean board or your computer or laptop that's connected to the board with registered devices. And this is what the active hub looks like. And the registered devices that can be connected to it can be an active vote, active expressions, or active expressions 2, which are the student response devices. Express polls are basically on-the-fly questioning. You can ask the students a question verbally and have them submit their responses via the devices. You can also have directions or questions on a flip chart page and have students submit their responses. And the last option is you could also use questions from other test banks that you have pasted into a flip chart and have the students submit their responses via the device. So basically what you're going to be doing is using the ExpressPoll wheel, and this is the button. It's a circle with a blue question mark on it, and when you click it, the wheel is going to appear, and the wheel has a number of different options. They can text in a response, meaning they could type in a word or a sentence. It's up to 160 characters. They can type a numeric response. They can use a Likert scale of, say, low to high. These are different actions, and I'll show you those in just a second. You can also send the devices a yes, no, or true, false question. You can send them a sort and order question, and you can send them a number of different types of multiple choice questions. So let's go to a page that has a question on it, and let's show you how this works. So the first thing you're going to do is click on the ExpressPoll button on the main toolbox, and the wheel is going to appear somewhere on the screen. Mine is here. You can actually click it and you can drag it around. And what you're going to do is you're going to move your mouse and hover over the answer choice that you would like your students to submit. So let's say I'm asking them the first question. I think there are about half boys and half girls in this line. Is that right? So that response would be a yes or a no question. So I can have the students answer true, false, or don't know, or yes, no, or don't know. So I'm going to do yes, no. The devices will be sent the question, and as students enter, their device name up here at the top is going to change from gray to yellow. So I'm going to select my responses on my devices, and you see number 5 lit up and number 4 has lit up. So if these are the only students I have in class, then I can go ahead and stop it using the stop button here. I can also set it a time limit and say, okay, students, you have 5 more seconds to answer, and then it's going to automatically stop as if I hit the stop button. If not all of the devices have answered and responded, you'll get this dialog box. One or more users failed to answer. Do you want to allow them to retry? If you click yes, it's going to give them a second chance to respond, but be aware that this will resend the question to all of the devices, allowing all students a second chance to re-answer the question. So I'm going to click no, and that's going to end the vote without getting those responses. So I have yes and no. Now let's just say that the correct answer was yes. I can click on this assign correct answers. And if I say the answer was yes, now yes is going to be green, and that's going to be indicated that it was a correct answer. I can choose to view these in a variety of ways. I can choose a horizontal bar graph. I can choose a vertical bar graph. I can choose a pie chart. And one of my favorite options is who answered what list, and this is going to allow you to see who, which devices, and what their response was. So if students text in something that might be not appropriate for class, inappropriate language or smiley faces or something that's not appropriate, you would be able to find out which device answered it and which student, and you would have proof in the form of this graphic to be able to use with that. So let's send another question. It says write the fraction for boys and girls. So again, I can come to my wheel, I can choose a numeric response and say, okay students, send me the boys fraction. And then I'm going to stop it. No. And now I have their answers. And what I can do with this, you know, I can choose the correct answer like I did before. Let's say the correct answer was 2 and assign it. Done. So there's my correct answer. I can also use this word seed, and that copies the text into the flip chart. So if I choose that, I now have a text box with a 2 and a text box with a 23 that I could do things with in my flip chart. So there's a 23 and there's a 2, and maybe I want to put that those are the answer choices, and then we can talk about them. And then I can also paste in my vote results as well, and it pastes them in as a graphic. So let me show you another one with this word seed option. Here is a question I'd send to my students and say, okay, give me some pros about bottled water. So I've got these responses in. I'm going to stop it. And using my word seed, I can see convenient and healthy. Now I can actually put those options in the box. And if I have 32 kids, I could have 32 different responses. Some could be repeating and some could be different, and then we can discuss them and talk about them before we talk about the pros to tap water, for example. So this video is how to use ActivInspire's ExpressPoll to question on the fly.